You're tuning in to the Black Hollywood Live Network, featuring news, interviews, and commentary on all things Black Hollywood. Hollywood redefined. From Los Angeles, California, presented by Maria Menounos and streaming live thanks to Akamai Technologies. This is Black Hollywood Live, This Week, featuring news and commentary on This Week in Black Hollywood. Black Hollywood Live, Hollywood redefined.
You're listening to Black Hollywood Live.
And now, the host for Black Hollywood Live This Week, Dario Kristen.
Hey, what's up, everybody? You're watching Black Hollywood Live This Week. We have a special edition. It's actually for the BET Awards Weekend Recap. I'm your host, Dario Kristen, and here joining me in the studio today is Courtney Stewart.
Hey, everybody.
And DJ Jesse J.
What up? Your voice sounds very, like you had a good time yesterday.
I know. I apologize for being a little hoarse. But I have a very special guest with me today. You know her from Fashion Queens on Bravo, and she's a great TV personality. Bevy Smith is in the house with us today.
Yay!
She's gonna break down all of our recap today with us for the BET Awards, and it is pretty exciting. I think this is one of their better ones, personally.
Yeah, it was pretty exciting.
It was an experience.
It was a true experience.
No pun intended.
And this year they actually started the BET Experience, which is for the fans. So the whole fan festival surrounding the award. So, you know, good for BET. They got a lot of money.
Mm-hmm. Viacom.
Viacom, baby.
They're doing something right.
We're not going to do the buzzer meter question this week, but we will be revealing it on the next this week's show. If you guys forgot the question, it is: should black people or should mixed people be considered black? You can go to our website and vote on the buzzer meter, and we'll read the results on the next show. So
that's right.
A whole other deep discussion.
A whole other conversation for another time.
All right, so Courtney, you're going to break down some fashion for us, the love it or hate it section.
We had a whole lot of fashion going on the BET Awards red carpet. Some good, some bad, some strange. But there were some lovely things that we're going to take a look at right now. So we're going to get you guys' opinions and see what you think.
Is it is it more of a new thing for them to change from red carpet to when they're inside?
That's a typical thing.
Yeah.
Especially if you're presenting, like you want to have a different outfit on for that. So we had a few of those, as Jesse has already alluded to. But let's start out with Miss Amber Rose. And she was wearing a Versace dress. And it was yellow. And it was a very day dress to me. It's a like yellow Stepford Wife almost. Sort of edgier
it's
to me.
It's pretty, but cute. It's definitely a lot safer and kind of more pedestrian than what we're used to seeing.
Yeah, great word.
Amber Rose, very pretty though. And I think, you know what, she's a new mom. Maybe she didn't want to show off all that she has, all of her new enhancements.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
the new arrival. And so, you know, I think it was a safe choice.
Yeah.
It's always better, I think, to be safe than sorry on the red carpet.
True
and
that.
She won the fans picked her for, was it Fresh Face?
Fresh Face.
Well, yeah. I mean, there's no denying that the face is gorgeous at all times.
All the time.
And that's a good color choice for her too, right?
It is bright, and it was very warm for the entire BET weekend. Yeah. So I'm sure that sundress sort of thing going on, it looked like it might have been a...
Don't call nice it a sundress.
It looks like a sundress.
It doesn't look
like
It
looks like
a
she's
sundress.
Going out to lunch with her friends. Like, she doesn't look like she's on the red carpet to me.
It's not
a bad dress. It's adorable.
I got to get used to the transition because I'm used to seeing different pictures of Amber Rose than this. So I'm my visual of this is I'm still thinking of the magazine Amber Rose.
Right. Oh.
So this is... It's cool. I mean,
I like it. She's a mom, so.
I mean, I get it. You know?
She's a new mom.
She's a new mom.
Let's keep that in mind. She's a new mom. Not every mom is going to kill themselves to get back into their pre-baby size. Mm-hmm. So perhaps there's a little bit of that going on. Perhaps she's hiding some things.
Well, yeah, but that. But just even though, just she's a, in this sense, she's a mom of the sense of. I mean, this is a. It's a. You know, it's a nice dress. She's covered up. It's cute. It's fun. It's flirty and.
Yeah.
She's killing it.
All right.
Well, I see we have different.
The judges have spoken. All right, so we got some okays on that one. Nothing loved, nothing hated, but it's okay. So good job, Amber Rose. We still think you're beautiful. Next up, we've got Taraji P. Henson rocking, I think it's Is My Lover. And it's like a leather, very low, sexy, some leather, some sheer. It's short. She has on some black strappy sandals, keeping it sexy. I think her body looks amazing in the dress.
She was killing it.
It looked great on stage. Yeah. The full look was a little off. I don't know if we can see it at home, but the hair was sort of like a loose side ponytail. She didn't have any jewelry on or anything, so it seemed a little not entirely done to me, but she...
Not wearing jewelry is the new...
thing. Yeah. I know. But then the hair was kind of like... I just came off the beach and had to throw it on a side ponytail to get there on time.
That's also, if you notice on the Oscar red carpets and all that, people love a tousled look.
That's true.
People like a very like, oh yes, I'm on the red carpet, but I didn't put too much effort into
it. That's true.
So it's a very relaxed look. I think that the dress itself kind of spoke volumes. And so, you know what? I'm not mad at the fact that she didn't do much else. The dress alone, the body, as you said, is amazing. I love the illusion panels. The leather, very hot, very trendy. She looks incredible. And I say kudos to Taraji P. Henson.
I agree. Mm-hmm.
She looks sexy.
She made it happen. Yeah. Sexy. Go. Yeah.
I'm just going to put it out there.
Anything else, Jesse? Yeah.
She delivered.
She delivered. She's sexy and kudos. Get it, Taraji. Yeah. Next up, we got Lil Mama in a dress. We couldn't find the designer for this one, but it is a very long... It looked heavy because she had somebody carrying her train in the back, and it's very beaded, very embellished, spaghetti strapped, V-neck gown. Yeah. And she had her hair was yellow, and it was
It's blonde.
That
you
is
said
yellow. No. That is yellow. That is not blonde. That is why I have a problem with
this picture gives it yellow.
Yeah, this picture gives it more yellow.
I saw it in person. She was right in front of us. It was yellow.
Was it yellow?
It's yellow.
Like
her
canary
hair,
yellow?
It's like darn near close. That blonde job was
golden.
Suspect.
It was golden.
It was a golden hue. That way we have a nice range. It was
critical.
A hue.
I'm too critical. But I thought the dress was lovely. Yeah. It was a lot of dress, though. She's a very, very petite woman.
Yeah, she's very
she
kind.
Is super
But
smart.
She looks good. Yeah. She looks really pretty. I think the makeup really softened her face.
Yeah. Because
she can sometimes look a little more angular and hard.
She can
very true.
Hard.
And she looked really pretty. I think she's growing into her looks. I'm happy to see that she's no longer going with the, like, you know, kind of hip-hop,
Brooklyn.
Meets Muppets kind of scenario.
You said that meets
more,
Muppets.
You know, kind of look that she was going
for
once upon a time. Yes, Fraggle Rock. You know.
I like the hair length on her, too. I think, like
That's
you said about
length.
The angles on her face, I feel like it really kind of... Yeah.
And look, and you know that she's also clean, no adornments.
That
no
is
accessories.
True. But there was way too much going on in the dress. I think I would have been bothered if she had any accessories on, because there was a lot of dress and a lot of embellishment. So, all right, Miss Lil Mama, you are doing it up. You have graduated from the Muppets to Regalness, darling. All right, so next up we got Naya Rivera and Emilio Pucci.
Emilio? Oh, I was like, that is Big Sean. She's just hot.
She's sexy to me.
Yes, okay, but are we talking about her sex appeal or are we talking about the dress?
Okay, yeah, it's a good point.
It's hard for me to even look at the dress.
I was going to say, just the overall presentation is sexy to me. The dress, the hair, she's giving me some, I don't know, Victoria's Secret runway hair kind of thing going on.
Is she holding a purse?
Is that a purse or a patch?
It's her clutch.
Okay.
Her clutch is down there.
It's kind of...
Well, it's weird the way it's angled right here, just because it looks like she has something on her leg or there's a weird cut with the dress, too.
I just don't know if I love it. I kind of feel like I might know where she was trying to go with it, and it didn't happen. Like,
but you know what I think we always have to keep in mind? This is the BET Awards, so anything kind of goes.
True.
So you can try out a lot of different looks. I don't think it's as... you're not under the pressure that you're under when you're attending, like, a Golden Globes or an Oscars or what have you. So I think there's a lot more... As it is with most music award shows, there's a lot more latitude allowed. And so... I don't mind this. I think anything goes, and I think that, you know what? She probably said, it's Pucci. And that was enough for her.
And that was enough for her.
And it's sequined, and that's enough.
And the colors are cute, too, aren't they?
Yeah, but I bet she said, it's Pucci.
It's Pucci.
And shut your mouth.
Pretty much.
Because it's Pucci. Because my dress costs more than, you know, the 10 dresses that went before me.
True that.
That's true that.
So, yeah.
Yeah, she's beautiful regardless. I would have liked it to, like, not have sleeves or something and maybe given me a little more skin up here.
Just, I like the sleeve.
It's Pucci.
It's Pucci. It's glittery. It's colorful. It's, like, green and black zebra on the bottom and then, I don't know, disco on top. Like, I don't know where it was, but hey, she put color.
I was gonna say, she stands out. The colors make her stand out.
And all that hair and face, you got it, girl. Naya, keep moving.
She gave me
keep
moving.
And she got her boo with her, so it's all good. All right, next up, we have Eve.
And silence.
No, I mean, I was just taking in this first picture I've seen. Yeah. I love Eve. I love, love, love Eve. I like this new hair on her.
Mm-hmm. Her body looks good.
Although a lot of people were getting her confused with Carrie Hilson yesterday.
Okay.
I can see that cut.
Well, you know what? Kudos to Eve, because Carrie Hilton is younger than she is. So that's a good compliment to be mistaken for a younger woman is always a good thing.
And for our viewers that can't see the pictures that are listening to us, Eve has a short blonde bob now. It's an asymmetrical bob, and she is wearing a melon coral colored short, basically a shift dress. It's not a shift dress.
It's a freakum dress, because see how tight it is?
A freakum dress?
Yes, for freakum.
It is mid-thigh, because she's tall. It's mid-thigh, and it's fitted, and she's got some turquoise jewelry and gold.
Perez Hilton is rashing on her, saying this was the worst outfit of the awards.
What does he say about it?
He just thinks it was very thrown together, and it's not, it just looks like throw up on the carpet. Honestly, for Eve, I like this for her. I don't know about the color. I don't know the shoe part, but on her with the hair, I like it. Maybe it might be doing it too much around the neck too. But
well, I think that was an effort to say it's not just a shift dress. Yeah. It's not just a day dress. I'm going to put on a piece of jewelry. And I'm going to put on these really great cuffs, and I'm going to give it more kind of a red carpet pizzazz. Yeah. But you can't please you people, so
there's no pleasing us, that is true.
Either way, she looks beautiful. The color is beautiful.
Her skin looks beautiful, and to me, that's the best accessory when your skin and your face is rocking.
And she's engaged to a billionaire, so everyone should shut up.
She could care less.
Gucci, and I'm engaged.
That she is, and say no more.
Exactly.
Right. Oh my god.
Can we just be here on
there?
We shut it down. Right. It's a Gucci dress,
and I'm getting engaged.
And I'm engaged to a billionaire, so lay down.
Eat a girl.
What's going on in your life?
All right.
All right, moving on. Yeah.
And that is a read.
Right.
We've got the adorable Quvenzhané Wallace on the red carpet. And her little flats and her little puppy purse. And she's so adorable. And she has, it's a ruffled, nude colored little dress. It was very girly appropriate, very age appropriate. She had her hair pressed out all flowy and nice. And she looked beautiful.
She gives you black girl realness.
Yeah. She does give you black girl realness.
Black girl realness.
She's a cutie.
Do we know what the situation with the dog purse is?
What do you
mean? It's like a trademark.
She's a child, and she's being made to work a red carpet.
Yes.
She needs some companionship.
Yes. It's like bringing her stuffed animal along.
Okay. So it's like her Linus blanket, basically.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Yes.
Don't try it. Don't come for
her. Ain't no one come for her. I want to know why she always has it. Is it a marketing deal for her? Like, I'm just curious.
It's her thing. She has a thing. That's her thing.
Okay. It was a damn question.
Everybody's getting testy in here. We're only on picture five.
Well,
we still got a whole thing to go through.
Don't make us do a Beast of the Southern Wild on your ass.
Put you on a boat and
hush
you away.
Right, exactly. Touche.
Either way, Quvenzhané was very poised on the red carpet. I just want to say she was adorable. Like, she just walked so poised and confident on that red carpet with all the crazy people running around and everything. I thought that was just beautiful to see.
Well, she's used to the big leagues, you know.
She's been to the season.
Oscars. Yes, exactly.
She's done
it. She did the circuit, so that was easy for her.
So, congratulations. You look adorable. Keep it up, girlfriend. Next up, Tatiana Ali.
Yes, look at my Tatiana. Wow. Gorgeous, always.
Okay.
She's a sultry siren.
Sultry.
What's the dress? Who makes the dress?
I don't have a designer for this one.
Okay.
But
I love it. I love a dress that's kind of biased, especially when you have hips.
Yes.
And I love a plunging neckline.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought she looked really pretty and really sexy and really elegant.
Yeah, so is the point to not wear the jewelry and more of the accessories now because you just want to feature the dress and the dress has so many different intricate cuts on it and designs? Is that why they're not wearing...
Does it sophisticate the dress more?
Yeah, I mean, you know, but there's a big, big, big movement towards just less is more when it comes to accessories.
Mm-hmm.
I like the sexy side hair.
Yeah.
You know,
I'm not, this picture is bad, but in person, she looked amazing. Yeah. I just don't like, honestly, the picture was just a bad picture, but in person, that dress was everything on her. It okay. really was. It was white. And well, what was the design on it?
Say, I mean, you seem to have an opinion.
In person, she was beautiful. Like, she, to me, I think she's probably one of the most gorgeous brown girls I see regularly in Hollywood. I think she's gorgeous. I have an issue with it didn't appear to me undergarment-wise that those were properly placed, and it bothers me because
what was improperly placed?
Things were moving, and it just wasn't.
Are you saying the Spanx? You saying she didn't have on Spanx?
I don't know. It just didn't quite look like it was all tied up under there.
See, this is that LA talk. I don't understand what she's talking about. What is she saying?
The boobies was swinging saying, a little bit wrong when she was walking the red carpet, moving. And her then all moving. This. It just,
you're being so.
She's
like,
saying that she had a little jiggly.
She had a little jiggly. Well, I don't want to say jiggle like it's a bad thing. Right. I think it's great that she's a little bit fuller, and she's obviously not trying to get bony skinny because she's been doing her shows at her size and she looks great. So I don't want to put
that
out there.
But she's also not a big girl.
No, so she's not a big girl.
She's an average girl, average size girl.
But for regular. Hollywood, like, she's definitely not like this narrow. Right. Like,
but I think if we're doing Black Hollywood Live, then I don't even think we should say
size wise.
Like, I think that that's a really slippery slope.
Yeah. Agreed.
Because then all of a sudden we're conforming to White Hollywood Live.
Right.
But to me, it's not about her size.
Well, you mentioned it a couple of times.
It's not about her size. Like, I think she's fine at her size. Okay. I think just like I'm fine at my size, I'm not interested in losing weight. But I also know that sometimes you should have, my mom would say, just like your panty line shouldn't be showing sometimes. Sometimes you might need to put the girdle on, and it's okay just to hold it in to make it look smooth and neat. It doesn't mean you're smaller. It just means you smoothed it out. That's all I'm saying.
Okay.
That's all
prep
I'm saying.
Prep work.
That's simple prep.
We got some fire in the room today
that's
with this fashion talk. I like this room today.
But I want fashion to does. Reiterate, I think fashion she's gorgeous, delivers. And I'm not mad at it. I just didn't think it was exactly right.
I want to know her skin situation. She was like literally glowing.
All of it. Yeah. Skin, the skin in general. Girl. It was black mm-hmm. entertainment television, so the black was on point. Next up, I'm not going to criticize anymore. Nicki
no,
Minaj.
You must. Otherwise, it's no fun.
Right. Nicki Minaj. Jesse, you can have her.
Miss Gina did her hair. I love it.
He was in love.
I do. This dress, though, when she tried to climb up them stairs, if you can't walk.
She was walking super slow.
She gave you Morticia Adams realness,
yeah.
sir.
Yeah.
She
said Morticia Adams realness.
What you will not do is ever criticize a woman because she simply cannot walk in her heels or in her dress.
Okay, but here's my thing about it, though.
You don't need to walk. You need to glide. And if you cannot glide, you need to have someone carry you.
Well, she didn't have no one.
She didn't have anybody carrying her.
She was not gliding.
No, but she had someone assisting her.
Assisting her, she did, yeah.
I would have preferred, though, she came down like she did at the beginning of the show in this dress to accept her award.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That would have been real extra.
No, I
felt it was like Helen Mirren madness moments of like, give me assistance.
I loved it. I loved it. I just, when she moved up the stairs, that's the only issue. I didn't notice it on the carpet. She had a different, this is the dress she had.
Yeah,
but then when she
dress.
Wore it in the thing and she went up the stairs, that's when I was just kind of like, oh, this looks kind of awkward. But visually on her, I think she looks amazing.
Yeah, she's perfect. Sure. She's divine in every way. And you know what? I think it's funny when people criticize her or try and speculate on whether or not her body is surgically enhanced. And I always say, you know what? No matter what it took to get there,
it works.
It's divine in every way.
It's
divine in every way.
It is.
It's like an artistic everything. Piece. Almost.
It is.
It really
Those
is.
Those breasts are just
Those,
bright.
Yes.
Like, just there. Yeah. And that hair, I'm speechless. And I'm not even that big on Nicki Minaj.
Yeah.
I thought she looked great.
It's a good look for her.
Beautiful, mm-hmm. beautiful, beautiful.
Now she stopped wearing costumes.
And I like the less
way.
Is more
which
makeup.
Is nice.
Yeah.
Her makeup.
No, she's totally done with the costumes and stuff. She's done with being spectacular and moved on to being an extravaganza.
Get a girl.
Yes.
I like that. Extravaganza.
That's
moving on to someone we all adore, Miss Brandy and Michael Cinco.
I thought she was the cutest thing.
She's in it's a nude cream colored high-necked shorter dress. Above the knee, not short. It looks like there's a little peplum around the back kind of going on, and it's a lace kind of stitching going on for those of you who can't see our pictures. And she's got wavy hair, shoulder length, instead of the super long hair. So that's
I love the neckline.
Different look.
I like the dress.
I love how the neckline makes her shoulders. Those arms
her teeth look spectacular.
Look
that's all I can see is just her white teeth and that smile.
She looks pretty.
Go, Brandy.
I will give one criticism. The shoes are a little heavy to me. They're a booty.
I could go with I could
laced up. I don't know. It was a little bit much for me. But
and that was probably her paying homage to the fact that it's a music event. Because the dress could be a little more daytime wedding moment
that's
happening.
True. Yeah. That's true.
And the shoes make it a little more rock and roll, casual. A little more kind of edgy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I think that maybe that was the effort there.
So she made the effort and came out pretty good. So congratulations, Brandy. Keep on doing what you're doing, girl. Next up, Janelle Monáe in her signature uniform of a suit, but she put it in white, all white this time with that beautiful hair and her face.
Maybe
she's
She's a cover girl. But I, the earrings, I loved everything about her.
Well, Janelle Monáe is a study in perfect simplicity, minimalist, and she's always like at her best when she's a minimal. Yeah. And, you know, but I do think that I would like to see a little more of, there was that one photo of her in a dress.
And a mini dress.
Yep. And she looked phenomenal. And she's got such a great rocking body.
She does. Yeah.
And so I would like to see a little bit more of that from Janelle Monáe. And I know the reason why she doesn't do it is because she doesn't want to hang her hat on that. Because so much of female artists, their sexuality really kind of leads the way before the talent does. So she wants her talent to be the statement. But I say kudos. I always love her uniforms, and I think she's an amazing girl.
The shoes are rocking, too.
I was going to say, I'm actually happy because she really doesn't wear too many heels.
Well, she started to wear heels now. Yeah. She's really, like, even in her video with Erykah Badu, she's killing it.
Yeah.
But it, just like you said, to kind of fem it up a little bit, just to add that is just sexy enough. You can see her leg shape, and then she's banging.
Yeah.
Everything with that hair too.
Four thumbs up for you, Miss Janelle Monáe. Yes. All right. So then we're moving on to Miss Adrienne Bailon in horror. That's a corally, very sexy J-Lo look for me.
Well, I happen to have a scoop on this.
Oh,
Adrienne is my friend.
Lovely.
And I ran into her in the elevator the night before, and she didn't even have a dress, she was going into a fitting. And she was like, I hope it fits. Because, you know, she's so tiny.
Mm-hmm.
She's
really
a minus
tiny.
Zero.
Little one.
She's a minus zero.
Wow.
And so, you know, but I have to say, yes, girl, you did that.
She did.
Because it actually fit. It looks perfect on her. She's gorgeous. I love a Grecian cut.
Mm-hmm.
I love a one shoulder moment. I thought the hair was gorgeous. Again, simplicity.
Yep.
We're seeing a lot of restraint on the red carpet at the BET Awards, and I don't think that that's something that we normally kind of attribute to the BET Awards restraint.
Never, no.
But everyone's growing up, I think.
Everybody
I
is.
I love it.
Keep growing, ladies, because you're growing well. So, Adrienne. Mm.
She looks like she appeared out of the carpet because it's all flowing
together. Yeah, and when she walked, she floated, and that makeup was just dewy and all kinds of J-Lo goodness to me. So, go, Adrienne. You did it, girl. All right. Next up, sexy fod Miss Sierra. In her leather, is that a halter and a leather?
It's not a halter.
Skinny skirt. I mean,
it's a bandeau.
A bandeau. That's what I'm looking for. And her leather sexy pencil skirt and some pumps, silver pumps, and that
a classic
hair.
Pump, right?
Yes, and that beautiful. I love the shorter hair on her, and I love that they curled it a little bit back away from her face. She did it to perfection for me. And this was Yves Saint Laurent, I believe. Yes.
She's come such a long way with her style, so I mean, I think that she just looks, she's grown. She's gonna be grown woman sexy now. You know?
Yeah, but see, I've been in the fashion now for about 6 years. She's someone else that I know fairly well, and we've done a lot of like shows and things together. And she's really been in the fashion now for a long time, and it's nice to see that she's finally in a space where she can do it and be accepted in it.
Yeah.
You know, because I think a lot of times when you come out very tomboy.
Yeah.
People don't want you to change because your audience is like, no, that's not what we bought into. But, you know, people evolve and they have to, their fashion has to evolve too. So
agreed.
I'm happy to see that people are accepting Sierra as being a fashionista.
So, okay, you said you've known her for a while. Would you say, because I feel visually her fashion has evolved another step once she started dating Future. Would you agree with that?
Oh, no. She's been a Givenchy kind of gal.
That's true.
She's gone to Paris for the shows, Milan for the shows, years before Future. So. Okay. No, I don't think he's done it. If anything, maybe she's
rubbed off on him.
I totally agree with it, because when they started dating each other, I'm just like, oops, she done upgraded Future, because ain't no one checking for Future like that. Now everyone want Future.
Yeah.
Sierra is, she's my goddess. I love Sierra.
Oh, wow, your goddess. Wow.
Honestly, I just think her face is ridiculous. Her hair, whoever does her hair, since day one, it has always, this, like, she could be out in some damn sweats or something, but her hair is...
That ponytail is always perfect. Yeah. Yes, 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 yes. Go Sierra. Keep it up, woman. Next up, we have Maya. Oh, not. No. Angela Simmons, actually. And I looked everywhere. I don't see her designer for this, which I can't believe. But it was described as a white space cupcake.
What?
By some online.
Okay.
It's a short, very, very elaborate, actually. I mean, structural.
It's very McQueen-esque.
Agreed.
Mm-hmm. It's pretty.
She hosted the pre-show in it. I think she looks pretty. I think, obviously, everybody's complaining about the boob structure. It's like a circles around the boob thing, which is a little different.
Or not, because, I mean, we saw Madonna do it, 20 years ago? Beyonce just did it for her European tour. So, I mean, you know, I think it's just, she wanted to be edgy. She wants to show people that she's growing up. She's actually grown.
Right. Grown.
I've known Angela for a long time, too. And, again, her style has really evolved.
Yep. Yeah.
But she's always had a mean shoe game. And you know, but that's always your starter point. You know, you enter in with the shoe. Up. Yeah. And then you work your way up.
Yep.
So I say kudos to her for taking chances now on her clothes. And then when she was in the actual arena, when she actually was at the award, she wore a gown. Okay. And it was also very structurally important, architecturally important kind of gown. It was really very pretty and very sophisticated. So I think, again, this is someone who's like, okay, now I'm putting y'all on notice. Right. I'm not a kid. This is not a pastry moment, darling. I know you may have thought that I was going to give you a neon sneaker for the rest of my life, but no,
it's
darling.
It's not happening.
We are having dinner. This ain't the bakery.
Oh, right, exactly. Exactly. We're having dinner. We're not having cupcakes.
Everything you just said, you hit it on the nail. For me, though, just she looked uncomfortable in person wearing this dress. Uh-huh. And I think that that's, for me, visually, that made it awkward. Because taking her out of that, it is a beautiful dress. And, I mean, Beyonce could rock. You know what I mean? Someone else could rock it. She just, maybe she's just insecure with wearing, this is her first time wearing something that edgy. I don't know. You could just see it. She just seemed very uncomfortable.
Is that a read?
No, it's not a read. I'm just saying, girl. Like,
well, I think it was a cool nod.
This dress or the one she wore inside?
The gown inside.
Which do you prefer?
Well, I thought that this was much younger and fun, and the gown inside was really very. It was. You could wear. No, she could have worn it to a gala.
Okay.
Yeah.
There we go. All right, Angela, taking chances. Keeping it interesting, I'm not mad, so keep it up. Yeah. All right, moving on, we have Kat Graham, and she was in Versace, and she's blonded it out. She's got some black, I'm kind of bothered by the length of this dress. I feel like it just didn't do anything.
Well, shoes are not high enough.
The shoes the skirt, I don't know.
But you know what, if she had on a super high heel, it would have worked. And also, too, the dress does not fit her correctly.
I was just going to say, it's very big.
It's a little big.
Yeah.
But do you know what that is? She's not a big enough star for them to alter it.
Makes sense.
Yeah, that makes sense.
That happens. There you go.
I don't know. I'm not feeling the blonde hair so much.
Agreed.
I feel like it's washing her out a little bit.
I don't know.
She's from Vampire Diaries. And
she normally has dark hair.
Very dark, striking girl usually. And the blonde, I think, just kind of...
It washes her out a little bit.
So I saw her at the Grammys, and that's when she initially did the blonde thing. But it was like Glinda from The Wizard of Oz, like bright blonde, like this big, and it didn't do it for me at all. So I prefer, if she's going to do blonde, I like this hair better. But she's like that girl, you walk into a room and you automatically look at her. She's just has this glow about her.
Mm-hmm.
And with this outfit, literally, I kept missing her. Every time I go anywhere and see her, I always point her out. But
the shoes look like they were made by a cobbler in the 1800s.
Like Salem, Massachusetts, yes, girl. Honey, yes. I know you play a witch on TV,
oh,
honey.
Oh, snap.
Okay.
We on the clock.
This is not the Salem witch hunt, darling. Take those shoes
off, because they are
darling.
Coming for you.
Yes.
She done got the straps got the up strap. And everything.
It's too much.
Oh,
she's
snap.
Soft gnome
I also
tooth.
Feel like maybe if she was going to go that
she
blonde,
was giving
maybe,
Sarah Jessica Parker realness from, what was that witch movie? Hocus Pocus. That's
wow, you took the Hocus Pocus.
Wow.
She should have wore like a ponytail back or something like that, I feel like. Maybe that would have been a little bit better with the dress.
Made have edged it up a little bit yeah. with a high ponytail. I don't
know. High heels on. That, yeah. well, honestly, she needed super high heels on. Yeah. And this, we wouldn't even be having this much of a discussion.
Nice. Discussion yeah. about it. All right, well, Kat Graham, you almost hit the mark, but not quite. You got a few things to work on, but we love you anyway. Next up, Michelle Williams.
Oh, love
and
my Michelle.
She's
I loved it.
Looking beautiful in white. It's belted.
And she's that size that you like. She is a 0 to 2.
Like
she is thin as can be.
I knew that was going to come back up.
Gorgeous.
I knew it was going to come back up.
She looks gorgeous in clothes. She is a hanger. That's what they.
She is a hanger.
And when in fashion, we refer to very thin people like that as hangers because they can wear anything because it just hangs off of them. It's a perfect drape.
In my defense, I don't want a hanger and I don't want her to be a hanger, but she does.
No,
look
she
nice
is a hanger.
But
she's naturally a hanger.
She's naturally a hanger. She's very thin. Her limbs are like just. Yeah. She was,
akimbo.
She. But it's very long. Ruffles and she has a split up the front. Yeah. I thought she looked sexy. It fit pretty well. I don't know if that black was intended to be sort of coming out at the top. I wasn't able to figure out if that was purposeful or if there was something under there we
girl,
weren't
you done
to
searched searching her dress for that.
As soon as I look at her, I see
I'm
it
like,
and
the
I'm
dress
like,
is
wait,
damn pretty.
Is that purpose? It is pretty. I'm not saying it's not pretty. I'm just wondering, like, is that a part
right.
of the dress or was there somebody didn't
was
tape
there a little
it properly?
Bit of a moment to happen?
Or maybe it's,
you know
it could have been the angle. You know, yeah. just the angle.
But it's that bustier top that if it's not taped in place or something, it can shift when
yeah.
you move.
Yeah.
So.
I'm sure it was taped, but you know, things happen.
Things
it was super high on the red carpet,
yeah.
right?
Yeah. I sweat it off.
Yeah,
Lord
exactly.
knows I sweat all my
yeah.
makeup off. So.
Yeah.
But she looks beautiful. She walked
gorgeous.
In. She looked glamorous, and I thought it was lovely.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Michelle, you look great. Keep it up. Next up.
Oh, God.
Lord have mercy. This
ooh,
is Jesse's
Montana.
French Montana. Doing it for the guys.
Yeah.
Doing something for the guys.
And I bet you all of everything he has on is like
$10,000.
Yeah. No, absolutely.
He's
and then he had an outfit change
yeah.
into like this ninja
yeah.
situation.
Sleeveless camo hoodie with red trim, white sweatpants, and I guess those are knee pads. I'm not actually sure.
Or they could be a part of this.
They could be a part of the pants.
The pants, yeah.
And sneakers.
Yeah.
So, jewelry.
I think he got what he wanted. He got the attention on the red carpet.
I mean,
he had the attention on the red carpet, and I'm sure that if he was to name check us, it would be along the lines of, it's Poochie Bitches. And I'm married to a billionaire, and so lay down. So, I mean, you know what? Let's never forget that hip hop is about being ostentatious
yeah.
and
truth.
Extra, and he gave us both of those
all
things.
Of that.
So
yes.
kudos.
And an outfit change. I mean,
and an outfit
that
change.
Is,
that's true. You can't. You
so
can't
kudos.
Miss.
I mean, yeah. I mean, I think that this is a very risque outfit.
Mm-hmm.
But I think that, you know, it's hip hop. And yeah. so kudos.
Hip hop, keep it up. Next up, we have Gabrielle Union and Zach Posen.
Always divine.
Mm-hmm.
And Zach Posen is one of the best designers for black women. He really cuts for hips.
Perfect.
He cuts really well for hips. And he cuts for a little butt as well. I think that's because he's
a
New Yorker.
Yeah, there's a little butt back there.
Well, he actually cuts for butts. Because I actually wear Zach Posen. He cuts for butts.
Nice.
I love
all
this.
Sorts
well,
of butts.
He cut very well.
Yes. But again, the trend, please let's acknowledge. No accessories.
Yep.
None, except very lovely shoes. Those
yeah.
ankle straps are fabulous. I will make one comment. It's not a criticism.
And it should be if you want it to be.
It is not a criticism. Because I think she actually looks perfect. She looks so perfect. She looks like a doll in this dress.
Yeah.
Like, it looks almost too perfect mm-hmm. to be real. But I read an article about her stylist before she was going to do the awards, and they were sort of asking who he was dressing and what she was going to do, and he had mentioned that she really wanted to have a very big fashion moment on this red carpet. And whereas I think she looks great, I just kind of feel like she is in, the body is sick on this woman. Yeah. Like, I just think she could go even further. And I would like to see
and
where she
goes. And she has gone further. But, yes. I mean, you know, I think maybe this was a classic Hollywood glamour moment. Yeah.
And some of the pre-BET things that she had done, like, 2 days before, I was like, girl, why didn't you save that dress for the red carpet?
For the red carpet, yeah. I mean, it's beautiful, though.
Like, she had to bring it. She's got a new original movie premiering tomorrow night on BET.
That's
so
true.
She had to bring
Jane,
it. Being Mary
check
Jane.
It out. But she looks beautiful, and she had her big accessory on her arms, Dwayne Wade. So they were doing real nice. Right.
And Gabby is one of the more fun people in Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
And
you know,
she likes to have a great time. And this dress allows that.
Yeah.
Get it, girl.
You can get it in that dress.
She was getting it in. All right, we're going to finish up here.
Oh, God.
I think that Jesse's sentiment of Miss Lala Anthony.
I love Lala.
People just really wanted to take her to the stake on this one. But, okay, I think that Lala knows her shape. She knows that she's an ample girl. She's got butt, hips, breast, nipped waist. So she's very hourglass, very figure eight. And I think that this dress, just it doesn't hinder that shape. Yeah. And it doesn't make her look too big or anything. And I think that it was kind of more, it's a risky moment because of the shoulder pads and, you know, kind of like the sleeves and the ruching and all of that. So I think, and then the back, of course, had those interesting accents.
Yeah. That was my issue with this. It just, I mean, I like it because it gives me like, you know, fourth member of the Pointer Sisters. Like,
right, yeah,
situation.
Raspberry.
Right.
And it's
right.
cute. I like that. I don't mind it from the front on, but seeing it from the back, it just honestly looked like, and it wasn't like, what did you say, call it an object or situation? I don't know. I was trying to figure out what it was. It just looked like a bed sheet just done wrapped up on the back of her shoulder.
Not a bed
and it was
sheet.
Just really heavy. I don't know. Like you said, for her body type, it just was so heavy on the back right shoulder. It really threw the whole dress off for me, being there and seeing it in person. From this angle, it's not as bad. It's giving me, it's like, jump, jump in.
Well, Lala's stylist, Jason Bolden, is a good friend of mine, and Lala's a friend of mine as well. And what I will say is I think she represents very well for women with TNA.
And she definitely has
she got
that.
All of it. She got all of it. Yeah, we'll just leave it at that. Keep the TNA girl working it, doing whatever you can, because you're doing all right. So that's our fashion.
That's our love it and hate it.
There was a lot of fashion. There was no real love it or hate it. We all just kind of were all over. We love, we hate, and we think some things in between.
Oh, you're so perfectly correct today, Courtney. What's going on?
Fashion's not black and white.
She's diplomatic.
She's so
fashion's
diplomatic.
Fashion's not black and white.
She's always.
It's all good.
Someone called President Barack Obama. She needs a little ambassadorship somewhere. Fashion land.
We'll move on to the non-diplomatic Courtney.
Right.
Some gossip and rumors now.
Gossip and rumors. There were a few situations at the BET
Awards
that was going on. And we're going to start out with B. Scott versus BET. So for those of you that don't know who B. Scott is, he is a fabulous, amazing, he's a blogger, he's a YouTuber, he is just an all-around, like, just entertaining, wonderful person, I think.
Mm-hmm.
But he was asked to help host the BET pre-show. And apparently he showed up in his full dress, and they did not appreciate.
He's dancing around the damn thing.
They didn't appreciate.
Bevy's gonna make you get it out.
And he was in his full dress, and they did not appreciate.
What was
his
full dress, Courtney?
He was divalicious in every way that
he got.
He
had heels on, makeup on.
He had heels. He had makeup.
On.
He had some fierce clothing, and he just
amazing
was
extensions.
On.
I will say his hair was
always. I just be like,
whipped.
Give me some hair.
Whipped.
Either way, BET didn't appreciate all that fabulosity all in one space at one time, and they told him, you need to go change and take your makeup off and take them shoes off. His feelings, he was obviously bothered by it, as he quoted on Twitter that it hurt his feelings.
So did he admit that on Twitter, that that's what they made him do?
He said that they did not ask they basically suggested that he do it. So it wasn't, he definitely was kind about how he said it, but it was very obvious
so
that it was
the
not
thing.
A request.
Here's the thing. We all have jobs, or we've all had jobs. And oftentimes, we can go to a job and someone will say, that's not really appropriate for this moment. Can you change, or can you shift it, what have you? I know personally, when I've worked with certain networks, which shall remain nameless, I've been asked to not have cleavage. Being on Bravo, they encouraged me to have cleavage.
Yes.
But I've worked with other networks that have asked me not to have as much cleavage.
But with that, don't you?
And yet they've still hired me, and they knew that I was known for cleavage. So I think that they could like the talent, but maybe sometimes they want it to be a little bit modified of a package. I'm not saying it's right.
No, I know.
But what I am saying is that it's part of the game.
Yeah.
And Courtney, as you mentioned earlier, you know, the whole thing about, like, even about a woman's weight in Hollywood.
Yeah.
That's a real thing. It's a real thing, right? So if you're working in Hollywood, you're an actor, unless you're, Mary McCarthy? What's her name? Is that her name? What's the lady? It was in the big movies now.
McCarthy?
Yeah.
Melissa McCarthy.
Coming,
yeah.
Yes.
Unless you're Melissa, you know, she's the only one that kind of gets away with that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, well, Queen Latifah as well.
Well, they'll have one or two that is sort of like the big girls, and that is what is acceptable, and then everybody else is supposed to be.
And I think that with B. Scott, maybe they wanted his sass, and they wanted his verve, and they wanted his very strikingly kind of independent opinion, but they wanted it to be a little more tamped down.
A little more packaged. Yeah.
And if you notice, even on Wendy Williams' show, from the first season to now, tamped down.
Yep. Know all about that.
So it's the game. It's the business. And sometimes, you know what? Like I said, I'm very fortunate that I'm on a network that's like, oh, we want you in all your beviness.
Yeah.
But that's not always been the case.
Yeah, right.
So I get it.
Yeah, I get it. And I get it as far as him doing it, too, because it's like, this is a big step for him. So, you know what I mean? You got to bite the bullet sometimes, and it'll give you more power to.
But they should have told him beforehand.
That's my next question.
But let me just say this, though, as we just talked about before we came on air. Hollywood, they won't say it. Say what you want from me. I always felt like, if you need me to look a certain way, then say that.
Yeah.
Don't like
they want
to
be
skirt around the issue. But it's ridiculous. Yeah. I just need to know, because then it's my choice.
Right.
And don't tell me that when I get to the studio, like, oh, do you have a camisole? No, I don't have no damn camisole. I'm traveling around with a camisole.
Bevy, there's not one in that purse over there?
No, I don't have a damn camisole over there. I have another pair of 6-inch heels.
Right, Bevy, because we need some more cleavage here on BHL. No.
I know, right? I'm so covered
all
up.
Up.
I'm so covered up. But you know what it was? I ran out of clothes for this event, but I knew I had to wear, like, designer clothes when we were talking about fashion. So I was like, oh, what? Because I have sundresses, but I didn't have a lot more designer clothes left. So I had to dig out my designer garment.
It's all good. And who are you wearing, by the way?
I'm actually wearing Etro and Prada shoes.
Beautiful.
Shoes are slamming.
For those of you who can see it, check
it. We need
it
to take
out.
A picture and just put it online.
We'll have to put it online so everybody can
see it. I would ask you to show them, but we won't even do that right now.
Yeah,
we won't
do that right now.
We need a shoe cam.
We should have one.
Well, I'm glad you don't, because my shoes are off right now.
Oh, well, that would be.
Sometimes it feels like that.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, B. Scott, it is an unfortunate situation regardless, because, you know, there's some angry people on Twitter. Right. His fans are angry.
Oh,
it's just not a good situation.
B. Scott is an amazing talent. I absolutely adore him. I wish him all the best. When I'm done with this, I actually need to call him, because I love him. I support him. Mm-hmm. And I want him to know that, you know what? This is just a hiccup.
Yes.
This is not the end all and the be all. Nope. And if BET doesn't want to work with him, he'll be A-okay.
There will be somebody else, honey.
You know, I've worked with BET before, and now I don't. And you survive. It's okay.
It's okay. All right. Keep your head up, B. Scott. It's all good.
It gets better.
And it gets better in terms of drama nonsense. Miss Omarosa, her mama, Claudia Jordan duking it out on the red carpet? Like, oh, what?
Claudia said that her mom punched her in the arm, but it was an old lady soft punch. That's what Claudia said, which was a bit of a read.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That was funny.
And she was telling everybody on the side of the red carpet, people next to us just talking about it. Like, Claudia, come on.
She done tried to start mad. So many rumors.
Yes. Like,
but you know what? I think if Omarosa's mom did that, then we know where Omarosa gets it from.
Well, that's very true. That's what I was going to say.
The apple don't fall far from the tree. It's like she's a feisty lady.
Yeah. Feisty lady. Dude.
She's like, if you're coming for my daughter, I'm going to punch you in your arm.
Right.
Take that, Claudia Jordan. You know what I mean? But
what
I mean,
you gonna do? You gonna punch me in the face?
I love Claudia, and she's a gorgeous girl, but she's thin. So I'm glad it didn't hurt her. No, I'm glad that.
Which I was surprised because on camera, I mean, not that she looks bigger. She looks like Anne.
Yeah, she looks
like
a girl.
Yeah, but in person, she had that V-neck down to her, and it just was sitting, and she was.
Yeah.
That big. Yeah, well, I hope that is not true, but Claudia says it is. So, Omarosa mom, maybe y'all write out an apology.
Anger management.
Anger management.
But if she was coming for Omarosa, I mean, you know, that's your mama. You can't mess with people's babies.
Oh, wait. But that happened on The Apprentice, which it's TV. Like, it's. Girl.
Well, I don't think it's just TV with The Apprentice and Omarosa, because those feelings go hard for Omarosa, for everybody that seems to have dealt with her. So, for some reason, everybody takes her personal. So, I think that speaks
volumes. Well, she's consistent. We'll say that.
A good thing LaToya Jackson wasn't there. Who knows what Omarosa's mom would have done?
Honey. Well, at least it keeps it entertaining, and Omarosa maybe should apologize. Next up, Rashida and Kirk, Love and Hip Hop Atlanta, are still together. Supposedly.
Allegedly.
It's okay. Nonetheless.
Well, it actually, I was really surprised, first of all, other than the fact that Rashida was even up for Best Female.
That threw me off completely.
They have to have, what, five people in a category?
Okay. Well, they could just drug Foxy Brown up out of the grave or something.
Hey, she was performing just last week.
Right. She fell down or something.
She fell down. Yeah.
But so Rashida is still pregnant, and I'm like, girl, I thought it was supposed to be 9 months. Like,
it does seem like forever.
And she was there with Kirk, and I was actually really surprised. I mean, I got hype about, because we cover Love and Hip Hop at AfterBuzz TV, and so I was like, oh no, that is some tea they had together, because just last week she was tweeting about, you need to call your son and take care of your family and do all this.
Because he was living the good life in a separation kind of a state, so.
And he didn't want to talk to nobody. He sat there like a good boy with holding her Louboutin bag, just chilling.
Perhaps it is a very smart business decision
on his half, because he needs some sort of business.
Hey, man, you gotta do what you gotta do.
It's not a read.
Yes, no, it's not a read.
It's a lot of reads going on.
It's
here
all
today.
Good. So they were together. They were on the red carpet.
That is a suggestion, Kirk.
Do we have a suggestion box?
Actually, we're going to create one.
Girl, I tried to talk to him yesterday on the carpet, but he was not having nothing.
He's not the star. His wife is. And that's still beautiful. So keep it up. And being that your wife is pregnant, you should be with her walking on the red carpet in that heat. Period. Right. Next up, what we got?
All right. So if you guys love and hip hop, I mean, any Deception, Scandal, all your favorite TV shows, make sure you guys check out AfterBuzz TV. It's our sister site. We do after shows for your favorite TV shows. And so it's AfterBuzzTV.com, and check it out.
All right, Courtney, we're going to continue. Ooh, we obviously watched the awards, and we just got done talking about the fashion, some of the rumors, but what about the winners for the show?
There were lots of winners.
We had tons of dang winners, and I was not actually surprised by any of them. Mm-hmm. Best Male R&B Pop Artist, Miguel.
Yay.
Makes love sense. Miguel.
He deserves it.
He is a peach. He has worked so hard for this success that he has now. I absolutely love him. He is infinitely talented. We've only seen him scratch the surface of the talent.
I love that.
He is, though. He's like an amazing boy.
I'm glad found his swag.
He found his swag. Yeah. And I'm glad that he sounded really good last night, because sometimes he dances a little too hard and his voice gets a little weird, but he's got so much talent.
Yeah, he's got so much talent. I ran to him in the airport, actually, when I was arriving, and, you know, he was there. He had his guitar on his back, and he's like, Bevy, did a big hug, and he's like, I'm going to be rooting for you. And he's like, you're always so supportive. I'm like, because I love you, because you're one of mine. Like, he's one of those people that you just want him to win.
Yeah.
And his manager, Falana Williams, is a dear friend of mine. And, you know, he just has a great camp around him.
He seems like a really
He has a really good camp, and he's a really nice young man. Yeah. He's the type of young man that you definitely would approve of if your niece came home and said, this is my boyfriend. You'd be like, okay.
Well, whoever he was sitting with in the audience is beautiful.
Yeah, that's his girlfriend. That's
I assume it's a girlfriend.
Aren't they
I mean,
she engaged or something? Yeah, they're engaged, right? Yeah.
You look good, girl. When he won that award and gave her a big old luscious kiss, thank you. That was beautiful. That was just a good moment.
Yeah. What I love about Miguel, he was on the Wendy Williams show one time, and you know, everyone compares him to Prince a lot, and mm-hmm. I'm a huge Prince fan, as we know. And he said, you know, when he's getting all this attention about Prince, he said, I can't even take the credit for this. He basically was so humbled and said, listen, I'm not even good enough to be on that level. You know, I appreciate all this comparison, but that man is an icon in his own category, and you guys are looking for someone to be the new Prince. He said, I'm not even on that level.
Yeah.
And a lot of young kids, I feel like, aren't humble these days. So for him to even embrace that type mm-hmm. of humbleness and not say, yeah, you know, I'm just like Prince. Exactly. Yeah. He took it to a different level for me. And he's got great music. So.
Great music. And I love the fact that he took rock and roll back to black folks because rock and roll is a African-American art form, first and foremost.
Yeah.
And people tend to forget that. So there was some talk on Twitter, he's supposed to be an R&B artist. Well, R&B, rhythm and blues birthed rock and roll. So he's just on the continuum.
Yeah.
So what you won't do? Let's talk about my Miguel.
Why is anyone trying to put them in a box?
Right, exactly.
Best new artist,
Kendrick Lamar.
I wanted him to win this one specifically, just because I think he totally deserves it. He's been in this game for a long time. Yeah. The fact that he hasn't even been recognized until now is just kind of like
crazy.
But congratulations to Kendrick for that one. Young Stars Award, Gabrielle Douglas.
I mean, isn't she the best role model for all of us? And we're adults.
Yeah. Like, growing up, like,
I want to be like, can
you mentor me? You worked hard. Like, she has a work ethic and a spirit-wise, she seems amazing. I've not met her, but I just...
Yeah, she's a beautiful young lady.
Beautiful. Got it together, girl. Keep it up.
And we were so proud of Black Twitter last night because no one mentioned her hair.
And I sat in the press room and I said, "Well, I wonder what we're gonna hear about her hair." Nobody said it.
Pulled it together.
Nobody said anything.
They were classy and not ashy last night.
Classy and not ashy.
For Best Actor, we got Jamie Foxx.
Fabulous.
Clearly,
Trayvon Martin T-shirt done.
Yes.
Sealed the deal.
Yes.
Amazing speech.
Yeah.
You know, bringing up Sidney Poitier. Harry Belafonte, you know, all the greats that went before him, you know, so that legacy building that the young people in the audience really needed to hear.
Yeah.
So I loved it.
And I love the Trayvon Martin t-shirt. Sticks so strong to that.
Yeah.
And actually supports it at every award show.
Not just like a fleeting moment.
Best female hip hop artist for the fourth year. Miss Nicki Minaj, because there's no
other
competition.
Who would be her competition?
They literally had to struggle for artists. Like, where do we go for this? Best female hip-hop artist.
Well, Rashida was on there.
Eve was on there.
Eve was on there.
Which, I love Eve, but it was kind of a struggle for, they rushed to put this album on for this category.
Yeah.
Love Eve. Rai Rai. Mm. I love Rai Rai, but not for that. And Azalea Banks, who I could see this year, something, but she more towards Best New Artist. You are not touching Nicki Minaj right now. Sorry.
She's fire.
Best Male Hip Hop Artist, Kendrick Lamar. Again.
A twofer.
Well deserved. Mm-hmm. Charlie Wilson received the Lifetime Achievement
Iconic
Award.
Performance.
Favorite performance of the night.
Epic.
Iconic performance.
We will get to that. Yeah. Then we had Best Collaboration was A$AP Rocky with Drake, 2 Chainz, and Kendrick Lamar, Effin' Problems. Big song this year.
Big song.
Chris Brown won the Fandomanium Award.
Yep.
Which, Chris Brown, those breeze, Team Breezy, y'all. Viewer's Choice Award went to Drake. Which that one I was kind of surprised about. And then Best Movie went to Think Like a Man. So I was kinda...
That threw me off a little bit. I was surprised on that
one. Because the other nominees were Beasts of the Southern Wild, Django, Something from Nothing, and Barkle, which that's...
Well, Think Like a Man was the big box office hit out of, you know, kind of that bunch. Maybe Django was on the same level, but I think Think Like a Man was really important from a an African-American point of view because the producer, Will Power Packer, is like, you know, a really big deal here in Hollywood, and he's one of the few Black producers who can really get a movie greenlit.
Yeah.
So the I think overall. It was the overall moment we're talking about here, right? So, yeah.
Because Beasts of the Southern Wild, that's just...
Yes, Beasts of the Southern Wild. Yeah, no, great, great, great film. But, like, you know, when you're thinking about it from a BET point of view, the filmmakers were white and, you know, so...
What really?
Yeah, yeah, and that makes sense in that sense.
All right, so let's get into these performances, because this was my favorite part of the whole situation. Chris Brown started off the show with Nicki Minaj. They did a nice little medley. I think we have a picture of from the performance. I loved it, because the Billboard Awards was kind of a snooze for me with Chris Brown, vocally as well. I think he was, I don't know what he was doing the night before, but... Last night I enjoyed it. He did some lip syncing, which I prefer when you're dancing the way Chris Brown dances. I want the lip syncing.
Yep.
Nicki Minaj had her grand entrance.
She did.
She didn't even touch the stage.
And she was rocking it.
And I love how simple she's just been doing with the outfits and things like that. And she had a very calm performance last night.
Yeah, but she was good.
Then we had Kendrick Lamar featuring Erykah Badu.
That was everything. Everything.
It was.
I love the way they ended that performance.
Me too.
I
mean,
well, I said on Twitter that Erykah Badu twerked off the stage. Twerked off the stage.
She did.
And she, as she should have, because that ending was everything. That, that is hip hop right there.
Yeah.
Loved it.
Luscious bottom on Erykah Badu.
Then we go to the, let's talk about the Charlie Wilson tribute. I mean,
amazing.
Indy Ari done came out and started it.
Yes. And Indy Ari looked beautiful in her sequin jumpsuit. And she was showing all those good curves that she has, which was nice. Because you know what? Just because you love being a Black woman and you are a righteous Black woman does not mean that you have to wear a caftan and a muumuu. No. So it was nice to see her in something that was form-fitting and showing off those gorgeous brown skin curves.
I loved the way it looked on camera.
Yeah.
It just had this sparkle to it. My only issue with
one request
was the camel toe situation.
She had some
cam
jumping off. Yeah. She did.
It was.
Well, you know what? It's very hard to wear
something
a jumpsuit.
Like that,
and not
That has lycra in there or spandex in it and that will not give you camel toe. Ask Ice-T's wife Coco.
I love and I love the color of the bandana.
That's what I was gonna say. I love the color of the head wrap. I just wish it had a little sparkle on it or something too. Just
I would have
like
preferred to see her hair out.
That would have been great. Right. But if she was gonna,
then why wouldn't
one?
She do her hair like yours?
Well.
Oh, that would have been real cute.
Wouldn't that have been cute?
Yes.
Well, that's like a rod curl
it
that
is
you
a
do,
rod
right?
Curl.
See,
this, but
done a rod
I would
curl.
Do it on my own hair if it was mine, but this is not mine.
See,
well,
at Black Hollywood
good.
Live, you get beauty tips as well
mad.
On here.
But see, that's what that makes it easier to get the rods without having to do the rods.
Looks really pretty, though.
Thank you.
Jamie Foxx and Stevie Wonder came out after her.
Yes.
Killed it. And then it was like a double performance because
I said it was the Black Pack.
Yes.
Charlie was like, y'all want me to sing?
Justin Timberlake, Pharrell, Snoop Dogg, Charlie got up. It was just really an amazing performance. The little dance.
I mean, he got Snoop to sing. Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, that's all I got to say.
No, Snoop Dogg sings. He was grew up in a choir.
I mean, I hear you, but he doesn't do it a lot all the time.
I just love this Snoop showed off his dreads. I love that he had the plunging neckline, very 1970s macking kind of moment.
Yes.
I love that he actually wore a suit jacket for this. You know, I thought it was really, really showing respect and paying homage to Charlie. Like, okay. And if you notice, like, they kept saying really amazing, genuine ad-libs. Like, you know, Pharrell was like, Black music.
Yeah.
And he's like, and then Snoop said something like, Get your glory.
Get your glory, yeah.
You know what I mean? So it was all those really amazing, powerful moments that were happening on that stage.
They understood what they really were tributing.
Yeah, there was a real sense of gravitas there. And I absolutely loved it.
Yes.
I was on my feet the entire time. Yes.
Yeah, me too.
That's the other thing I loved. His voice was amazing. His energy was amazing. And the audience reaction shots were just fantastic. It's nothing like seeing everybody like jamming to the same music at the same time. It was beautiful.
All over social media, everyone just keeps talking about this performance.
Yeah.
And, you know, for me, I have found a... Because I always done loved him.
Right.
I done found a new love for Pharrell Williams. Because... Yeah. I've never seen him in person, met him in person until this weekend, and his style is crazy.
Yeah.
And it's so simple, but just on him, it just really, really works.
Well, he owns it.
Yeah.
Yeah, he does. Skateboard P.
And I've noticed that dress shoes with no socks is coming. Was it ever in? Because it's here and now.
It's it's a waspy.
Okay. Yeah.
It's very Hamptons.
Yeah. Pharrell was killing it, though, with that. Next, we had Robin Thicke, one of my other favorite performances of the night.
Yeah, this was incredible.
That was number two for me, number two.
Yeah.
I mean, I love Justin Timberlake, but this is Robin Thicke's year.
Robin Thicke with Pharrell and T.I., incredible. And then, I've worked with T.I. and with Pharrell. And to see T.I. in such a really kind of carefree manner, so great to see that. Like, that's how he really is.
Mm-hmm.
But he has a whole persona going on when he's working. So it was great to see him, just let loose and do the old man dance and everything, doing the old man dance. And, again, Pharrell, just an amazing, producer, singer, rapper. He does it all. And Robin Thicke. Hello, white chocolate. Done.
Yeah.
It's hard to believe that he's not biraciial.
Yes.
It's like,
crazy.
Alan Thicke and Gloria Loring, but both singers. So he gets it from his parents. He gets it honestly.
And I love these three together because you could totally see them hanging out. It reminds me of Real Husbands of Hollywood.
Right,
they just seem fun. And this performance was that and more.
Yeah.
R. Kelly...
Amazing.
He killed
Let me just tell you what I said. This was my assessment on R. Kelly's medley. He's going to show you people tonight that he has more hits than he does court cases.
Preach.
That's what he was like, guess what? I'm going to give you all a snippet of just about 20 of my hits, okay?
We're 20, only going to go there.
Which is only a modicum of what I could do, people. Mm-hmm. And then I went to see his show.
Oh, yeah. It was unbelievable.
Tell us about the show.
Oh, it was incredible. I mean, he was just in perfect voice. I did not like that he refused to do a costume change. He wore that on his show, to his show as well.
Oh, really?
I said he was a frugal R&B icon.
I've noticed that he's been really into this whole, spiked thing.
Well, you have to understand that he's late.
Yeah.
Basically.
Because he was working on more hits in the closet.
And he's country.
He's very country.
True that.
So he's late. So he thinks that he's really doing
it. He's killing it right now. Yeah.
He was doing it.
As long as you sang
it. Now I'm behind.
Tell him no.
I came out with half on a baby.
Yeah.
He came out with half on a baby.
I was like, got to pull them R. Kelly CDs from under the
Hey, listen, I put on 12 Play. I can't
really
even lie. 12 Play is on rotation. 12 Play is on rotation right now.
Through it yesterday.
I was going through it, listening to that. I was like, I got to get it on my iPad. It's not in my iTunes, and everything is still, some stuff still on CDs. But he did it. He did things. He did that.
Mariah Carey.
She looked amazing.
She was in a jewelry box.
Yes,
she was. It was her perfume box.
She was in a gold vault, darling. It was like something from the set of Goldfinger.
Yes.
It was everything.
They opened that box up. It
was
everything.
This direction the whole time.
The chandeliers on the side, the outfit, the gold. I mean, she delivered visually.
Perfect body angle.
Yes. Mimi is just that she's one of the last of the great divas.
Yep.
And she's earned the right to be a diva.
Mm-hmm.
And so guess what? She wants to stay in the jewelry box and hold that one pose, honey, and just give you kittenish coy moments. Kudos, girl. You're the one who can do it, and
yeah,
no
can.
One better not say a damn thing about it. You've earned the right.
I love that she did not move. I love that she was the backdrop.
Yeah, she was the backdrop.
She said, y'all can perform in front of me,
y'all just
and
dance.
I will remain here and be Mariah Carey.
Yes.
I was waiting for the wind machine.
I was a little annoyed.
No, you know, with the wind machine, she probably feels like, okay, you know, Beyonce is now.
She's
that.
Conquered
so,
that.
So, you yeah. know. Yeah.
She said, bitch, I got a jewelry box.
I have a jewelry box. I have a gold vault.
Right. You know. I just woke up in right. this. The lip syncing was really off. I don't know if it was just the camera thing or
yeah,
what.
Yeah, because I couldn't tell in the at the award show.
I can tell. Yeah.
It was on TV. It looked bad.
Really bad.
Like, it looked bad.
When she would like do her high notes, like her mouth wouldn't even open before the note hit, or she would do the first one then not do the second one. It was just like, no, you're Mariah Carey, like, and I know you still can sing.
Yeah.
I know you can't do like what you used to be able to
How
do.
How do you know that?
Yeah.
Girl, have you been talking to Nick Cannon?
No, girl, I've been seeing her at her concerts, girl.
Oh, really?
Listen,
she does blow it out.
She blow. No,
she
can
still got a voice.
Don't let him backpedal.
I'm not
backpedal. Don't tell, sir.
She can sing. Mariah Carey can sing, but she cannot sing like she when she first came out.
Well, she was also 19 years old.
No, I get
that. Well, no, that's no excuse because Uncle Charlie's been around for 50 years
that's
singing.
True. Boop. So but no, she's I just children wanna, now, and that changes things.
I don't know. No, Mariah. Look, Mariah Carey is legend.
She
is legend. My thing is though, I want to hear you sing. Like, especially you're gonna keep throwing like young Jeezy on your track. Like,
that's true.
She loves hip hop.
She does. And
I wonder why she actually lip synced though. I mean,
love that she does. That's my
bad. Well, maybe like, she why? Just I mean, wasn't she was just full strong voice. Maybe she hadn't had her proper humidity in her hotel room or whatever it is, and she just didn't want to give bad Mariah. She wanted to give the best, so she had a track ready. She was like, I'm not up to it. I'm gonna just sing along with my track.
But I mean,
but it's not like it's overly, she doesn't have over like a lot of heavy vocals on this, so yeah. It's like, you know, so it's weird.
What do you know about heavy vocals? That girl is screaming in three different octaves in that song.
I'm just saying it's not like her typical, you know, single where she's just throughout the entire song, it's like crazy.
I think
vocals.
You men need to lay down and leave Mariah Carey alone.
Well, let's move on to the next one.
All right, fine.
But overall, visually, that was a great performance.
Okay, thank you.
Let's
good
go
save.
To J. Cole. J. Cole Miguel, I mean, I love these two together. I want them to come out with an album together. I want a best of both worlds type album with them.
Yes. That hopefully doesn't end in pain and lawsuits.
Pain and lawsuits, exactly.
We wanted the completion of that.
We want positive karma for this one. But, I mean, it was a simple performance, but I loved it. It was great mixing R&B, hip-hop, and they're young. It's what we needed.
Fresh, they did it.
Tamela Mann.
Take me to the king.
Take me to the king, honey.
She did that.
She did that.
She killed
she
it.
Did that. I mean, yeah. I've loved Tamela since watching her in her little plays, or big plays, excuse me. But she did it. She did it. Her hair was everything.
She was epic, and she's such a pretty woman.
She's beautiful.
She's a very pretty woman.
And so nice, and just so, like, that fun, positive
energy. She's a
good
Christian.
Yes, she is.
And what she said in the press room about collaborating with any artist, she would want to do something with Celine Dion. Yeah.
I actually Dan stood up for that one because I was like that would be an
now
epic.
Please like make that happen. I would be all
Celine would
it.
Probably love to sing with
I
her.
Think that would be
Ciara and Nicki Minaj.
Okay,
that
now.
Girl swept.
Ciara was amazing.
Her dance move.
Can I tell you the entire press room got up and moved over to our table. Because we cannot contain ourselves when Ciara done came out and whipped the hair down, got down on the ground.
We were like, it's coming, and she swept
she did it.
And what about the suggestion of making it rain by having the money all
I
over
have
the
money.
Clothes?
Yes.
Okay, you gave me an explanation that I'm okay with.
She was.
I had a problem with the clothes.
What did you think?
I felt like, especially when she got to Body Party, like I love that it's sort of like a sweatsuit because I love that style about her. It takes me back to Aaliyah, who I'm obsessed with. But I just wanted like, I was like, I wish she had on like leather pants and just like, it looked really light and flurry and I just didn't get, I wasn't getting it. And then, I mean.
And
that,
now it makes sense,
It
right?
makes sense, but I still don't love it. Like I
but
just,
you're
maybe
also
everybody else reigned and then she was something else. Like, I don't know. I just wanted a little bit more on her. Yeah. I don't mind the other girls in it, but I just want a little something else for her. Maybe her money pants were like.
Well, it's funny because we were talking about maybe switching those to
platinum.
Just the black, you know, harem pants. But
Black harem parents?
Yeah.
That would have been horrible.
No, I don't believe in that.
To match the color of the bra. But actually, I think, honestly, it does need to keep these pants with that top because you're talking about it. It's different. It's swag.
Make it rain.
Yes.
It's a culture.
And look at her. Her face is beat.
Oh, it's flawless.
She said, I'm going to come with short hair to the party and leave with long swanging.
Yeah.
Swinging across the floor.
She ain't giving up her hairstylist to nobody. She has that person tied to her, dedicated.
Can we just say whoever's doing those abs, helping her with them?
Let's be clear. Ciara is a very thin girl.
She dances all day long.
I was waiting for that to come out.
She's fit.
No. But she dances all day long. It's like she doesn't need any help with her
whole life.
Yeah. It's like,
I mean, that's been her whole thing.
She's not like, it's not like she.
She didn't have to go from this to try to get that.
Right.
Like, I get it. Okay. I get it. I just respect it because it still works.
No, you know what I'm saying?
She's keeping it right.
Her body's tight.
Yeah.
Body's tight.
So congratulations, Ciara. You did that. One of my favorite performances was Beanie Man, Elephant Man. I mean, this.
Well, I didn't like that they didn't give you any introduction and tell you what was going on.
What was happening.
Yeah.
It was kind of weird, that transition.
It did just kind of happen, because then I thought, like, French Montana and Nicki Minaj were going to end up popping up on stage, and I was like,
I didn't know what was going on.
I was like, please don't do that.
I was thoroughly confused.
I just appreciated they had some bright colors on. Red pants, you know, the turquoise pants. They were real summer. They were bringing it.
I'm not going to lie. On the red carpet, I saw Elephant Man. I was like, what the heck is he doing?
All right, you back. Right, man, I miss you.
And they came out here, they did it. Nicki Minaj was getting in her seat.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. With her drink in hand.
Right.
She was going.
So, awesome.
I love Nicki. And I love the fact that she enjoys her artist.
Yep.
She was very gracious when she was on the, in her acceptance speech about other artists, right? Mm-hmm.
About the actors and her previous acting and
how
she respects them. So that was exciting.
Yeah, it was nice.
And then we had Jen. Oh, before we get into that. Well, that's all right. Go ahead. We'll go into this one, then we'll finish it up with Miguel. Janelle Monáe and Erykah Badu had a killer performance. I love Erykah with this hair.
There's nothing she can't do wrong.
She does everything.
That's just such a power force, those two together.
Yeah.
I mean, I thought the room was going to explode.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, that's on fire right
the
there.
The dog at the end was
the poodle. I think they scared that poodle, though. Everybody was hollering.
Ran off stage,
we can bring him out and all that noise. But that song, Queen.
Killed
Janelle Monáe.
Iconic moment for them.
Proud.
The BET Awards, I thought the performances this year were epic. Except Miguel had one situation. I don't know if y'all remember when he did.
Could you guys see this?
How many drinks? He was started up on top of his box, and he jumped down, and then he was doing, you know, the little split jumps.
Yep, the three.
And he wasn't wearing no underwear.
Oh.
And at the final split, he done popped up, did a twirl. And his thing went up, and his butt was just hanging out.
You stop it.
It was crack. Full on plumber's crack. Full on plumber's crack. Crack for days.
He pulled a plumber out?
Oh, he did.
Because
we were saying it the whole time. We were like, oh, he's going to show some crack. And it showed.
Mm-hmm. So all right. You did that, Miguel.
Well, thank you, Jesse, for that wonderful recap.
Ended it on the crack.
On the crack. All right, well. Before we move on to the final categories, we also want to remind you guys to go to iTunes and download our previous episodes and listen to our podcast. We got Black Hollywood Live this week. We have Black Hollywood Live Portraits. We have Black Hollywood Live next and Stand Up, Sit Down. And we will love for you guys to rate and comment. We definitely listen to those comments and pay attention to what you guys are saying so we can improve the shows each week. All right, the last part of this wrap up here, we have the BET Weekend Experience Overview. Basically, in a nutshell, I was working the BET Pavilion, and what we had in there were a bunch of different interviews. We had Nick Cannon stop by. We had the cast of The Game. We had Let's Stay Together cast. We also had Bow Wow and Angela Simmons. It was for the fans. A lot of people didn't know this, but it was literally open to the public. So all the local fans and people were traveling all over the world even to come to this to meet the stars of these shows. And there were panels set up. There were film festivals. There was food, games. You were really able to intertwine with all the different people that were there. Bevy was hosting a wonderful panel with Pharrell. And Bevy, how'd that go with Pharrell?
It's great. I did something called Genius Talks. I interviewed Pharrell one-on-one and then Nick Cannon. So kind of like in the actor's studio. just me and those guys on stage one-on-one for 45 minutes straight.
Good times.
So the fans loved it. I mean, it's been hitting the social media all over. This is their first annual time doing it. So they said it was such a huge success that they're planning on doing it again next year.
Fantastic.
Yeah, so it was a great weekend followed up with concerts. There was R. Kelly, we were saying, performing. Beyonce, I saw her Friday night. I am truly a fan now.
She flew through the air before Nicki Minaj did.
She did, she did. And I see where the wind machines come from as well. Yes. She had like 80 in the front row. So it was just a bunch of festivities that, happened, a bunch of concerts and things going on for the fans. So we were all there and we were able to cover it and we were really excited about it. And congrats to BET.
Yes, y'all did it.
Y'all did it.
Everyone was having a really good time this weekend.
Yeah.
Now, Bevy, we're going to wrap up the show, but where can your fans find you?
I'm on Twitter, at Bevy Smith, B-E-V-Y Smith. On TV, right? On Bravo. Yeah.
Of course, watch you on Bravo.
Yeah, we're on hiatus right now, but my show comes on Sundays at 11:30, and I have two fabulous co-hosts, Derek J and Miss Lawrence. They're fabulous, famous hairstylists. They're known for being on The Real Housewives of Atlanta. Mm-hmm. And so we have a lot of fun. I always say it's a kiki good time. Yeah.
Kiki good time. Mm-hmm. All right, Courtney, where can your fans find you?
You can find me on Twitter at Stuart Starlet.
At Jesse. DJ Jesse J.
And you can find me at Dario Kristen on Twitter and also on Facebook. Thank you guys for tuning in to Black Hollywood Live this week, our special BET Awards Weekend recap. Be sure to tune in for our next show next week. We're going to have a couple people stop by possibly as well. And thank you guys for tuning in. We'll see you then.
Yay.
From producers Maria Menounos, Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, Dario Kristen, and the entire BHL staff, we would like to thank you for tuning in to the Black Hollywood Live Network. If you have questions or comments, tweet us at BHL Online or email us at info@blackhollywoodlive.com. For more exclusive content, visit blackhollywoodlive.com. This has been a presentation of the Black Hollywood Live Network. The views expressed here are those of the host only and do not necessarily reflect the views of BHL or its owners or principals.